How do you make a baby? The awkward question you probably wondered about growing up until you were old enough to attend an even more awkward sex education class. In school, you were probably taught that for humans to make a baby, you need an egg cell to fuse with a sperm cell. However, in the wider animal kingdom, this isn't always the case. Plenty of animals reproduce asexually, and a select few experience what's known as parthenogenesis. In Greek, the word parthenogenesis literally means virgin creation. It is a form of asexual reproduction where an embryo develops without the need for an egg's fertilization. Because of this, the body must compensate for the missing genes not provided by the absent sperm. This can happen in a couple of ways. First, in a version of parthenogenesis called automyxis, the egg can merge with the cells called polar bodies, which are leftovers from the egg production process. This generates offspring that are like the mother, but not exact clones. They are generally all female. In plants, parthenogenesis can occur by apomixis, which involves reproductive cells duplicating their chromosomes via mitosis. In this case, offspring are genetically identical to the parent. What triggers parthenogenesis is not fully understood, but it's thought to be linked to environmental stressors in some cases. It may surprise you, but virgin births in the animal kingdom are not all that rare. For small invertebrates such as bees and tardigrades, parthenogenesis is relatively common. Among vertebrates, parthenogenesis is not the norm, but it's not as rare as you might think either. So far, it's been observed in over 80 taxa. The phenomenon is also known to occur in plants and algae. Various insects, fish, reptiles, and even birds have been found to undergo parthenogenesis. Females of some species, including some lizards and snakes, exclusively reproduce through asexual means. These are known as obligate parthenogens. Then there are species that experience spontaneous parthenogenesis. These are the ones that generally try to reproduce sexually, but occasionally give asexual reproduction a try. Most recently, a female stingray in a North Carolina aquarium became pregnant with no male stingray involvement. Despite claims of a shark-ray hybrid, this is most likely a case of spontaneous parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis has even been induced in some species that would reproduce sexually, fruit flies for example. Parthenogenic mice have also been made in the lab. However, without this helping hand, mammals are incapable of parthenogenesis. Therefore, humans are not able to reproduce by parthenogenesis. As with all mammals, this is due to an important genetic process called imprinting. Imprinting involves specific markers, which are inherited from our parents and can affect how certain genes are expressed. Some genes may be switched on and others off by this process. If we were to have only one parent, as is the case during parthenogenesis, some essential genes wouldn't get activated at all, rendering offspring unviable. That said, occasionally, spontaneous parthenogenetic development of an oocyte can occur, which is thought may result in the formation of a tumour in the ovary, but definitely not a little parthenogenetic prince or princess. Thank you for watching Eye for Science. Please subscribe for more science videos.